Hi everyone, my name is Khan, and today I will be reviewing the Kaplan OAT course and the OAT Destroyers. So yesterday I made a video on free and cheap resources you can use to study for the OAT, and so today I figured I'd make a video on the more expensive end of studying for the OAT. So the great thing about Kaplan is that they do all the work for you. So they divide up the lesson plans and have their quizzes and homework ready for you on the spot. So if you're the person who doesn't like to plan, this is great for you because all you have to do is just log in and they have the lesson plan and the homework, quizzes, and everything ready for you to go for the day. So Kaplan provides you with 7 full-length exams that are designed to mirror the actual exam of the OAT. In terms of layouts, everything you see on the page is how it's going to be like on the actual OAT, and timing. They time you and they give you breaks just like on the actual OAT. You also get a dry erase board and a marker, because on the actual OAT you don't get pen or pencil, so that's kind of similar to the real experience. The exams are a little harder than the actual OAT, but if you add about 10 to 20 points to that, that's kind of similar to what your OAT score would be like on the actual exam. After a diagnostic test, they give you a summary of your score. They give you a subject with all the subtopics under that and how many you got right on every subtopic and how many you got wrong on the subtopics. So that gives you an idea of what you're strong in and what you're weak in, and then you can go back and study it. Okay, so one of the negative things about Kaplan is obviously their price. They are very, very expensive. So I recommend signing up for a Kaplan account about a year in advance so you can see all the deals and price drops that they do throughout the year, so you kind of get an idea of how low they can drop so you can wait for the same thing to happen the following year. Another thing that's really bad about their course is that their professors don't really teach you anything per se. Their classes are very short and basically just give you a refresher and glance on every single subtopic. So if you are relearning the material from the beginning, or you didn't have a strong background on the materials to begin with, I would not recommend this, because it's very quick and brief, like 10-minute video on a single subject. So I would recommend going to Chad's videos or YouTube for a more in-depth tutorial. Okay, so here we have the online course for Kaplan with the pre-recorded lectures. As you can see, Kaplan has study plans prepared for you and helps keep you on track. And this is particularly helpful for those who are not sure how to approach studying for the OAT, because they plan everything out for you, from what you do before class to the class lectures to after class quizzes to help further your understanding. And you can see on the side that they have 7 practice full-length exams to help you. Not only are there quizzes, but there are after class homeworks that are provided. So there are question banks recommended and performance summaries from all of your scores. And so for the question bank, you follow a series of questions on how you want to be tested and what topics you want to review. So then you would just click create an assignment and they will generate a series of questions for you to work on as extra practice. Next, we have recommended practices that are calculated based on your diagnostic test scores. The diagnostic test is what you take before the course so that they can show what your strengths and weaknesses are for you to work on. Lastly, the performance summary is just a summary of how you're doing the whole time. Okay, so on to the OAT Destroyer, which was probably my least favorite way to study for the OAT. You can get it from eBay for about $100 to $150, or you can literally just ask around and someone is bound to have it. I asked about 20 people and one of my friends actually ended up having the PDF version of it, so I got it for free. So basically, the questions were very difficult and it was very, very draining trying to get through the packet. I ended up doing the organic chemistry and the physics packet, and I only got through half of it because I kind of gave up at the end because it was just so hard. But I will say, doing the questions, although they were difficult, they really helped you understand the subject. Like really, really deep down understand the subject. Because the two topics I did it for, the OCHEM and physics, despite giving up, I ended up scoring top 97th percentile on the actual OAT. And so that I mean, in the long run, it really helped me, but just at the time, I just couldn't get through it. So this is what the Destroyer looks like. The section starts out with key notes that you should keep in mind of, and personally, I think making flashcards for the first section would be very beneficial. Every subject has hundreds of practice questions for you to work on, and the answers are in the back. Okay, so the last review I'm doing will be on the Prometric flashcards. That I don't remember how much they sell for, because one of my friends actually ended up getting it, particularly for his MCAT review. But guys, don't get that. It is, first of all, it takes you about literally an hour to break up the flashcards and like get everything in the right order. Second, it goes in such deep, like in-depth details that are very unnecessary for any standardized testing. So that's a really quick review. I don't know where I put the cards. I probably threw it away somewhere, but it was very much useless. Anyways, I hope you found this video useful. If you have any further questions, you can send me a message on Instagram or leave a comment below, and I'll go ahead and answer them as soon as I can. I hope you have a good day and happy studying.